Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. A sumptuous lunch, a delayed start to the afternoon session, and the afternoon session is always a disaster. So I think we have the perfect recipe for a disaster right now. I hope the eminent panel seated here, and I not only hope, I am very sanguine that they will ensure that we don't go to sleep, really. I'm certain. Yeah. I think the panel has already been introduced, therefore making my task much easier. I'll not repeat the introductions. I'll just try to put the session in perspective. You know, I think all of you are aware of what is the contribution of MSMEs to the Indian economy. I do not need to go into that, really. You know, the figures speak for themselves, whether it's in terms of exports, 35%, 45% of industrial manufacturing, second largest source of employment in the country, and employing more than 60 million people, that is 6 crore people. What is important is that the sector has been growing at a compounded annual growth rate of almost 12% over the last 4 to 5 years, 2004 to 2008, data reveals that. And the unique feature of MSMEs in India and other developing nations is that they use capital much more efficiently. They have also displayed a very, very high degree of perseverance and resilience against competition, and particularly in the recessionary conditions which prevailed over the last couple of years also. And given this background, I'm not surprised when I read a recent report by Deloitte Touche and the US Council of Competitiveness. The report has come out with a ranking for India as second in manufacturing competence after China, ahead of South Korea, the United States, Brazil, and Japan. The report also talked of India's large talent pool of scientists, engineers, skilled workmen, and commended the quality of its management practices. And the report concluded by saying that within the next 5 years, we would have certainly and considerably narrowed the gap with China on the competitiveness front. And I have absolutely no doubt that MSMEs are the engines which are going to lead this race in narrowing down this gap in the competitive manufacturing competence. But also I would like to put things in perspective as far as the Indian MSME sector is concerned. Data of scheduled commercial banks reveals that there are about 90 lakh odd accounts of the MSMEs, and out of that, the micro sector is about 82% of the accounts almost, which means businesses less than 25 lakhs and invariably even less than 10 lakhs. And then there were certain figures which came in the last issue of Business India, which said that borrowers with credit limit of less than 10 lakh constitute around 98% of all loan accounts, but constitute only 27% of the total outstanding credit. And figures, whatever may be right or wrong, but the fact remains that it's the bottom of the pyramid in the MSME sector which has the largest numbers, which is growing, but probably needs much more access to credit. And that is where I would like today's panel, while talking about the new age financing options for MSMEs, and are in the process of strengthening the ecosystem for equity and risk capital requirements of MSMEs also through our various products. Mr. Reddy in the previous session also gave an example of the Kanpur cluster amongst others, where the BDS provisions are going on, and we have to look at products which also integrate the BDS providers into the overall ecosystem. Coming specifically to what SIDBI has been doing for the MSME sector, last year was our 20th year, and in these 20 years, last year has been the best year in terms of performance, where our sanctions exceeded 35,000 crores and our disbursements exceeded 92,000 crores. And obviously these go to the MSME sector, since we are the principal development bank for the MSME sector. The specific products which we are looking at, or which we have introduced during the past, I think one of the major products which we may be discussing as we go along is factoring in the MSME sector. The factoring turnover in the previous year was around 33,000 crores, constituting about 1% of the total bank credit. A host of issues plagued factoring, and SIDBI has played a role in this by coming out with a report through Dun & Bradstreet, which has touched upon what are the major issues plaguing this area, and we have submitted the report to the government for appropriate action. We hope that this is one front where we would be able to now take things forward in times to come. A well-performing SME capital market is a critical need for SMEs anywhere in the world, equally well in India, not only for meeting the equity requirements of deserving and growing SMEs, but also for providing an efficient exit to private venture capital invested in early stage companies. This would encourage more and more venture capital investments into early and innovation-based enterprises. I think many of us would be aware that SEBI has recently carried out certain very important modifications in the provisions of the issue of capital and disclosure regulations, in addition to releasing guidelines for market makers. I think these guidelines will mark the rollout of the SME platforms on the stock exchanges, and SIDBI is already active with one such exchange, the NSE, and Indian Angel Network also is part of that partnership really. So an SME exchange is very much on our agenda, I think, and that too in the short run. Access to credit without collaterals is a problem which invariably plagues the startups and even the existing units as they grow really. And this is where SIDBI has played a major role along with the Government of India, Ministry of MSME, in setting up the Credit Guarantee Trust for micro and small enterprises. The trust today provides a guarantee for loans up to 1 crore rupees given by banks and select other institutions which are covered. And the guarantee can range from about 62.5% to 85% depending on the size of the loan or the target segment, whether it's women entrepreneurs or micro enterprises, up to 5 lakhs which give the highest coverage at 85%. The scheme covers only those cases in which the lending is without collateral security and without third-party guarantee, thereby promoting the concept of lending based on project appraisal and the viability of the project rather than based on collaterals. In regard to venture capital, we're going to have, I think, a specialist talking on it, but SIDBI has set up an institution known as SIDBI Venture Capital Limited, which manages two SEBI-registered venture capital funds, the National Venture Fund for Software and Information Technology, and the other is the SME Growth Fund. The first one is a 100 crore fund and the second one is a 500 crore fund, both of which have been committed. And we are now in the process of setting up a third fund known as the Indian Opportunities Fund, which would be a 1,000 crore fund. Venture capital essentially looks at high risk, high return kind of projects which would not get financed in the normal course through the banking or other financial institution network. And there's a very high likelihood of the project failing, but it's the two or three winners out of the many projects that you finance which make up for the venture capitalist basically. So it's a very specialized area, and SIDBI was a pioneer in this area, and we intend to take this industry forward through our third fund now. But venture capital as of now essentially, you know, looks at the slightly upper end of the MSMEs basically, and there is an acute need for providing risk capital to MSMEs at the lower end also, and that is where SIDBI has stepped in with a risk capital fund of 2,000 crore rupees supported by the Government of India. And the idea is to provide risk capital or equity support to well-deserving MSMEs which have the potential to scale up but don't have the capital to leverage loan funds. SIDBI has come up with a number of variants of risk capital like equity, preference capital, optionally convertible debentures and optionally convertible debt, etc., besides the subordinated debt product. And we feel that the introduction of this quasi-equity type of product would help the MSME.